Hi, I'm Francesca Nalin, and I'm glad to present you our study conducted at the University Hospital of Verona in Italy with the title Safety of Drug Provocation Tests in Adults with and without Clonal Mast Cell Disorders. Mastocytosis is a clonal mast cell disorder with a high risk of anaphylaxis, and drugs are known as one of the possible triggers, even if data concerning the severity of hypersensitivity reaction and the type of drug involved are often missing. The drug provocation test is the gold standard for diagnosing drug hypersensitivity, but is still scarcely studied in mastocytosis. Our study aimed to assess the safety of DPTs in adults with mastocytosis and to propose evidence-based recommendations for clinical practice. We analyzed the characteristics of previous DHR and the outcomes of DPTs in patients with mastocytosis and in general population, enrolling a total of 204 patients. We included 104 patients with mastocytosis. Patients with a previous DHR were classified as CMD group A, while patients without a history of DHR but with no known tolerated drugs after the diagnosis were defined as CMD group B. In the control group, we collected data from 100 patients referred to our allergy unit for a history of DHR. In mastocytosis group, we performed a total of 250 DPTs, 184 in group A, of which 6 with a culprit drug while the remaining with alternative molecules, and in group B, 66. In the control group, we performed 231 DPTs, 18 with a culprit drug, while the remaining were conducted with alternative drugs. For what concerned the outcomes of DPT, we observed in group A, 1 skin reaction after receiving an alternative molecules, no reaction in group B, and in control group, 5 skin reaction with the culprit molecules. It is interesting to observe that up to 35 patients tolerated quinolones, a class of antibiotics well known for its ability to activate the MRGPRX2, triggering direct mast cell degranulation. In mastocytosis group, 14 patients underwent DPT with ASA and 11 patients with ibuprofen, and all of them had a negative DPT. Our findings provide clinical relevant information. They support the safety of DPTs with selected drugs in patients with mastocytosis, and this is of particular importance given the widespread hesitation to prescribe or administer untested drug to this patient. Based on our findings, we propose a new algorithm. In patients without a positive history of adverse reaction to drugs, medication tolerated before the diagnosis of CMD are allowed, and DPT could be avoided. In contrast, in patients with a history of drug reaction, the culprit drug should be avoided and an alternative drug should be tested with a DPT. Thank you for your attention.